Julie.
Hello, Anne. How are you?
Hi, Eoin. How are you?
Julie, you've chosen this hair salon as your first choice in Dublin. And why is this one of your favourite places?
For many reasons, it's my favourite hair salon, like it is for a lot of people. Eoin Wright is one of my favourite Dublin people, and one of my favourite people as well. We've collaborated a lot, a huge amount on a lot of my work for my first album and my second album. And we're also great friends, and it's just brilliant fun to come here. It's part of, I mean, I feel it's part of home for me.
Is your impossibly beautiful? Is that cause I'm waiting? Is that cause I'm looking? Is it just cause you are?
What is it about working with her that you enjoy?
You're given all the scope to do what you want. She listens to you. A bit of a control freak sometimes. She's a hard taskmaster, but it's just great to get out there. The salon is a little bit different.
Cause you catch me.
And then working with Julian, she's pushing me all the time, so it's great to be arty.
You've no idea how beautiful you are.
And would you be on standby for Julie for big events? You know, maybe a concert or...
24/7.
Yeah. Really?
Well, actually, his other string to his bow is that he's a really good photographer. And he actually took the shot for my first album. The cover shot on that was taken by Eoin, and he took a lot of my press shots. And the photo ended up in the New York Times, actually.
Julie's next choice of location is Christchurch Cathedral, which became a big part of her life when she sang there as a chorister. And your actual spot was here.
Yeah, absolutely. This is where the altos were. It's actually magical, and when I look at it, I just think and just feel the feeling of it.
My head is full of you.
It was a place that I spent about 8 hours a week for 3 years. It was a wonderful, wonderful time. Brilliant way to improve your sight reading as a musician, because the music is flying in every week. It's different every week, you know. And a wonderful bunch of people, fantastic people that I met here, and I'm still friends with a lot of them.
How did being in the choir here in Christchurch, Julie, affect you musically?
My love for acoustic spaces like this has never left me, and it's actually my primary love. I absolutely adore performing in spaces like this, or churches or cathedrals.
Love is a tricky thing, and it brings you lightly.
We know you very much as an individual composer and performer, but in a choir, you're one of many.
Well, I think I still hear my music as a whole. If I'm composing a song, I'll hear all the parts as well. So I think that kind of comes from being a choral singer. You're used to hearing the tenors over there and the basses here. All I've done now is that has developed into a trombone or a double bass or whatever. So that informed my orchestration.
You gave me grace. You gave me grace.
Herbert Park. Very much part of your Dublin turf.
Yeah, it is. I've lived around here for the last while, and I really love it here. It's a beautiful place to come and just collect your thoughts, really.
So typically, you're maybe in the middle of a composition or arrangement or orchestration. You might come here for a bit of a breather, a bit of...
Yeah, when you have a problem and you're not quite sure where it's going to go, I would often come down here and sit here and just think for a while. It's a fabulous place for that. Hi, Keith. How are you doing?
Fascinated by the charm of a beautiful, delicate thing.
Back again. Brilliant to see you again.
Yeah, you too.
No, I mean, as you are my number one taxi driver.
Number one taxi driver? Me? Woohoo!
I can say that because I am Taxi Queen of Dublin, so I know. I haven't learned how to drive yet still, believe it or not.
No, don't. It's not worth it. It's a waste of time. You're better off taking taxis.
Well, I'll keep you guys in business anyway.
Just keep me, Julie. Don't mind the rest of it.
The beautiful train needs to be preened and elegant daily tending. But the power is known and monsters grown on stealth of fear.
So here's Julie, the National Concert Hall. You have performed here many times in your role as in various choirs along the way.
I have, yeah, numerous times. This place has a huge amount of magic for me, because as a choral singer, it's the sort of place that, you know, it's the top of the pile.
Are you daunted in any way by the idea of having to perform in front of a full house?
Really, really scared, actually, in lots of ways. Oh, bewildered, looking for a lover.
But you will have an orchestra with you.
I'll have my own Pages Orchestra, which is just going to be from the Pages album. So it's people that I've worked with a lot.
So maybe you'd give us a sample of what we're likely to hear.
Okay. You're impossibly beautiful. Is that 'cause I'm way? Is that 'cause I'm welcome? Or is it just 'cause you are?
And Julie's next gig in the National Concert Hall is on the 29th of May.